I've covered visual phasing, which usually needs at least three siblings or more to look at, and people have asked about visual phasing with two people. I've already done a video on that, and of course, somebody needs to ask the question, what about with half siblings? Can we do visual phasing with half siblings? And of course, the answer to that is yes. There's some caveats, but yes, you can do that. So let's go over visual phasing with half siblings today. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. Now, as with visual phasing with two siblings, there are some caveats to visual phasing with half siblings. And that's just because half siblings have a unique feature that you don't see in full siblings. And that is, we need to remember always that half siblings only share one parent. So there's one parent in common, and then that half sibling has a different parent from their half siblings. There's different ways that we could have half siblings. So first off, if we have three full siblings, a 3FS, then we're just going to use our regular visual phasing stuff. If, on the other hand, we have two full siblings plus a half sibling, then we are going to use two techniques. We're going to use a two-person visual phasing, and we're going to use a half-person visual phasing. Now, this half-person visual phasing can be one of two ways. The half-person visual phasing can be basically a half-two visual phasing, or it can be a half regular visual phasing. And you'll see here as I go through this a little bit. And finally, if we have the other category, and that is going to be if we just have two half siblings, well, then we're going to use the half two-person visual phasing, which is what I'm going to be showing you today. I've already made videos about the visual phasing, and I've made videos about the two-person visual phasing. Let me briefly talk about half visual phasing, and then we'll get into the half two visual phasing technique going through, which is really just very similar to the two-person visual phasing. Now, for the half visual phasing, one thing that we need to remember is that first principle. I'm going to draw three pairs of chromosomes here for person A, B, and C. And C is our half sibling. Now, if you remember from our visual phasing principles, we have both maternal and paternal chromosomes. So I'm going to say that this is a maternal chromosome, and that maternal chromosome is here, and all of these share a mother because they share one parent. So this is a maternal chromosome as well, which means that these other ones are going to be paternal chromosomes. Now these first two, they share the same parent. So this paternal chromosome and this paternal chromosome, while they may be different, they came from the same parent. But for our half sibling, their paternal chromosome is completely different. So what you see from this is that a half-sibling visual phasing with at least three really involves a couple of things. First off, for this chromosome, this is just regular visual phasing because they all have the same parent. For the next part, though, you'll notice that there's only two of these, and so this is going to be your two-person visual phasing because they have the same father as well as the same mother. So we'll be able to use some two-person technique on this. And that leaves us with our half-sibling. And unfortunately, one of the things that we have to realize here is without any other information, we can't really do any visual phasing on that last chromosome. We can identify it as either paternal or maternal because we know who the common or uncommon parent is, but we can't do any dividing up into segments for that because that chromosome is not actually being compared to any other chromosome in order to identify recombination points. So you can see that with three people, one of them being a half sibling, you're just doing a combination of the full visual phasing and of the two-person visual phasing. But with just one half sibling and one, I guess it's not really a full sibling, they're both half siblings, so you have two people, what we have to do is we have to do really a modified version of our two-person phasing. We only have two people, but we already know that we're only going to be able to do it for one chromosome, and that's what we're going to be going over today. So step one, we need at least two siblings' data uploaded to GEDmatch. In this case, we're going over how to do half-sibling visual phasing with just two people. So our first principle, again, is that each chromosome is separate and unrelated to the others, and this is really important with half-siblings because one of those chromosomes we're not going to be able to do a whole lot about. So we're going to do a side-by-side comparison, and with just two people, we're only getting really one set of graphics here, and this is what it looks like. Now, if you've watched my other videos, you know what these color regions mean, but we'll go over them really briefly. First off, color region one, solid green and blue, represents a full match. But for half siblings, there should be no full match, so you really don't need to worry about this color region at all. If you do have solid green as a full match with half siblings, then they're also related in another way. Now the yellow and green with some blue is the half match regions. And the red that usually has some yellow and maybe some green with black underneath is going to be a no match region. Where the color changes is our recombination points. And principle three, your full match cannot be adjacent to your no match. We don't need to worry about this because we should not have any full match with half siblings. So our step three now is to go in and draw our recombination lines, which we've drawn right there. Now, every chromosome, this is our fourth principle, every chromosome pair has a maternal and a paternal chromosome. Again, this is important because they share one parent in common and the other they don't. We're going to create two chromosomes for each person. And now we get to principle number five. Each chromosome is made up of grandmother and grandfather segments. So the whole goal of visual phasing is to divide up the chromosomes to know what you receive from each one of your grandparents. But we have principle 5A for half siblings. One of these chromosomes is for unshared grandparents, which means we can already do step 4A and we can label one of these chromosomes as the unshared parent chromosome. Now, in this case, what I've done is I have gone through, and since ultimately we want to try to identify grandparents, I've put the two names of the grandparents for the unshared set of grandparents in each one of these. So person A has Brown and Townsend as grandparents, and person B has Faye and Ray as grandparents. We're not going to be able to do anything else with these chromosomes right now because we don't have anything else to match them to. Now, if you happen to have another half sibling that shared the same Faye Ray as person B, well, then we could use them with this same technique to divide out how that Faye Ray chromosome is. But for these, really all we need to work with is the other chromosome. So on to principle six, the segments switch colors at recombination points for that person. Each recombination point is going to be assigned to a single person. Rarely do you have recombination points in the same spot for multiple people, and you rarely have them in the same spot for both of that pair of chromosomes. So we want to color the largest no match region. That's because we don't have any fully matched regions. A no match region is going to tell us some information about both of the chromosomes. So here we know that A and B are going to be different colors, and I've just done maroon and orange in this case. Before we continue, if you want to support our work, there's many ways that you can help. In the description below, there are links to our show notes, to free guides, as well as our website and blog. However, the most important thing you can do is leave a comment and share this video with your friends. We continue to grow thanks to viewers like you. Step six is we want to use our matches with known relationships to identify these segments. So let's take a look at this match that is a Hankinson match, and it's not that big of a match, but we're able to get a lot of information from it. And we can see from this match that we have an overlap in this region, and we have an overlap really right here that butts up right on that recombination point. Well, with this, since we have this maroon overlapped, I know that this has to be a Hankinson. So we're going to go through and we're going to label that as a Hankinson. And because we can now extend these segments and add the new segments as needed. So in this case, we are going to move this Hankinson segment this way to cover all of this. And we're going to add this as a Hankinson segment as well. And then since we already know the Hankinson, this is going to be our other one, which is Anderson. So we've got one match so far, and we've basically already gotten half of this chromosome identified. We can now identify the recombination points if there are any. And in this case, we do have one where Anderson changes to Hankinson. And so we can label that as person B. Now that doesn't change anything as far as our next step, which is to extend segments across recombination points, because we've already extended that segment across that recombination point. But if there were other places that you could, then this would be the time to do it. Now, we want to go on to our next step, which is to repeat steps 6 through 9, looking at our matches with some other matches. Well, I happen to have another Hankinson match, but it only matches person A and right here at the end. That means that it is Hankinson for person A, and since this is a no-match region, that's got to be Anderson for person B. So, in just 2 matches, remember when if you watch the video on visual phasing for 2 people, I actually used 3 matches, but with 2 matches, I have one of my 4 recombination points identified, and I also have 75% of my segments assigned to a grandparent. So when we're dealing with just, you know, the one chromosome like this, because we've taken out the paternal chromosome, we can get a lot of information with just a few matches really quickly. Now, again, you're going to do this for all 22 of your chromosomes. And this is just going to be that common parent that you're solving for. If you happen to have another half sibling that has the other parent, the uncommon parent, in common, then you can solve for that other one. But without that, you're really just going to have to use DNA painting with some matches on that side to try to figure out where those overall segments would be. So visual phasing is possible with half siblings as well as with just 2 people. You're just applying some different techniques to change the process up based on the information that you have. Now, if you'd like to see a different way to do visual phasing that I call segment phasing, then check out this video up on top here. But if you want to learn something else about DNA, then there's this video down below. I think we're gonna have sneezes during the live stream today.